सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणं विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रेणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिर्मलम् अपारं सर्वेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं नमत्वन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यम्। So continuing with the example for Abhasavada, the example given with Ghatakasha, Matakasha, actually it's a mixture of Avachinnavada and then Pratibimba is talked about. This is something that Bhagavan Panchadashikara has dealt with in the sixth chapter of Panchadashi as well. And we have seen the example. Now in the exemplified, you have seen Kutastha. There we have to look at the Tippana. So two options had been made earlier. Buddhi Adhisthana or Vyashti Ajnana. Buddhi is anyway Vyashti. So Buddhi Adhisthana or Vyashti Ajnana. Adhisthana, either of the two are called as Jivaha. Now, in the Tippana, Swamiji says, Jivaha, Buddhi Pratibimba iti, Avidya Pratibimba iti cha Vakshyamanatvad Atra Pakshaduyam Suchitam. This is what we saw last time. Now, this Chidabhasa, we saw Chidabhasa, then the formation of Chidabhasa is by the reflection in or abhasa. Abhasa or pratibimba, either you take it, there is a reflecting medium needed. There is a medium needed. In abhasa, there is some medium. In pratibimba, there is a reflecting medium. Now, this medium is either avidya. Avidya, another name for avidya is karana sharira. Or it is buddhi. Another name for buddhi is sukshma sharira. So, either the Chaitanya, Brahma Chaitanya, which at the individual level is called as Kutastha Chaitanya. It is just a name change. There is no difference between Kutastha and Brahma Chaitanya. Now this Chaitanya reflects in the Upadhi, or there is an Abhasa due to the Upadhi. That Upadhi can be Karana Sharira or Sukshma Sharira based on whichever Advaita Paksha it is. Both are Advaita Paksha, Prakriya Bhedas. They are just Prakriya Bhedas. Now, Jiva is not really Chidabhasa. Only Chidabhasa cannot be Jiva. Only Buddhi or Avidya definitely cannot be Jiva. And Shuddha Chaitanya, either called as Kutastha at the individual level, also cannot be Jiva by itself. Now, what are the combinations which can make a Jiva? That is analyzed in the point number 3 in the Tippana. Atra Chidabhasa Shabdena Buddhya, meaning Antakkarana. Buddhi is Sukshma Sharira. Antakkarana can be called as Manaha or as Buddhi also. Basically, Sukshma Sharira, which travels after the fall of the Stula Sharira, Anmrityu. But prana ityadi are not talked about more, but they are also included. Each of the koshas becomes an upadhi. बट वेयर इज दी प्रतिबिंब पॉसिबल, इवन आभासा पॉसिबल, इन आभासा ऑल्सो देर हैज टू बी सम सिमिलरिटी. द मोर द सिमिलरिटी द मोर द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ आभासा, एंड इन रिफ्लेक्शन द मोर द प्रॉक्सिमिटी, द मोर द प्यूरिटी, द मोर द क्लैरिटी, द मोर द रिफ्लेक्शन इज क्लियर. दैट हैपन्स टू बी इन बोथ केसेस बुद्धि. बुद्धि इज द क्लोजेस्ट and it is possible to mimic as abhasa, and buddhi is swachha, being in sattva pradhana or sattva sukshma sattva sattva karya, thereby it also becomes the best reflecting medium. Karana sharira is also reflecting medium, stula sharira is also reflecting medium, but stula sharira when it comes up in waking state, the reflection is not the only thing which is available. Other than the noise in the mind, the gross level noise is also available. Therefore, in stula, it is very difficult to hold on to the reflection. You have to find it in the sukshma. Of course, in the waking state. But in the sukshma, the buddhi is there. Karana sharira definitely is there at all levels. Now this karana sharira alone is manifest in sushupti, where there is no kriya possible, as in no activity is possible, no thinking is, mental activity is also not possible because the mind is folded. Therefore, the only place it is possible in is in waking inquiry, and that inquiry is at the level of the buddhi. That buddhi which can make the chaitanya be clearly understood is taken as the medium for reflection, although others are also mediums, but still that is the best medium to understand as well. Upalabdhi sthanatvena, as an upalabdhi sthana of chaitanya atma tattva. So with that background, let's look into it. Atra chidabhasa shabdena buddhya, meaning antakkaranena sahitah chidabhasa grahyah. Chidabhasa means not only chidabhasa but antakkarana or buddhyas sahita. And chidabhasa itself needs a medium also. So medium, as we saw yesterday, day before, the chidabhasa is not possible without a medium, and that medium is happens to be buddhi antakkarana, and the reflection or pratibimba if you take, or abhasa of what? Chaitanya is there. So chit, chit abhasa itself says chit is there. Abhasa is there. So two components are there in chit and abhasa, and chit abhasa is not possible unless there is a medium which is buddhi. So all three are there. When you say only two are mentioned, but chit abhasa includes chit within its garbha. Therefore, all three are included. Grahyah, tatha cha antakkaranam athva avidya. तथा च अंतकरण अथवा अविद्या तत्स्थ चिदाभास. और द अदर वे टू लुक एट इट इज अविद्या इज ऑल्सो देयर. अविद्या इज कारण शरीर एंड तत्स्थ तस्य इज अविद्यास्थ चिदाभास. तद उभय अधिष्ठान कूटस्थ चैतन्यम च इति एतत् त्रयम् मिलित्वा जीव इत्युच्यते. ऑल थ्री हैव टू बी देयर. अधिष्ठान कूटस्थ चैतन्यम अलोंग विद द अदर टू, they together they are called as jiva. So all three have to be there. Now this is the siddhanta. Puropaksha is seen in options given. Kevala antakkaranasya jivatva uktau ghatadehe jadasya api tadapattihi. So if there is a question as to kevala antakkarana, why don't you call kevala antakkarana as jiva, there are such pakshas also. Mind is jiva. Keval antakkarana, if you take keval antakkarana as jiva, what will happen? Antakkarana is jada. Then jada-jada bheda you cannot make. Of course, you can make jada-jada bheda in vyavahara, but if you call one jada as jiva, why is not the other jada jiva? That can also be jiva. Therefore, ghata dehe. घटपटादि ऑल्सो कैन बिकम जीवा. देर इज नो डिफरेंशिएटिंग फैक्टर बिटवीन वन जड़ा विच हैपेंस टू बी दिस स्थूल शरीर विच इज पार्ट ऑफ प्रपंच. जड़ा अंतकरण इज सूक्ष्म शरीर विच इज ऑल्सो जड़ा पार्ट ऑफ द प्रपंच. घटा इज ऑल्सो जड़ा पार्ट ऑफ द प्रपंच. वॉट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू? बोथ आर जड़ा. सो इफ यू जस्ट टेक जड़त्वम एज अ कॉमन फैक्टर बिटवीन अंतकरण एंड घटपटादि, देन अंतकरण बीइंग कॉल्ड एज जीवा, घटपटादि ऑल्सो कैन बी कॉल्ड एज जीवा. So that is the possibility. Sorry. Aswachchatvad ghatadehe tanna sambhavati iti chet. Now in that itself, the Purvapakshi is arguing. Let's say buddhi is swachcha. Which is what you say, swachcha buddhi. If the buddhi is swachcha and ghatapatadi is not swachcha, thereby buddhi can reflect. Ghatapatadi cannot reflect. This is your argument as well. So why not say that buddhi being swachcha itself, it becomes jiva, whereas ghatapatadi not being swachcha is not jiva. Na sambhavati aswachchatvat ghatapatadehe aswachchatvat ghatadehe tanna sambhavati iti chet. Meaning tanna sambhavati jivatvam na sambhavati iti chet swachcha darpanades tadapattihi. Then what will happen? Darpana is swachcha. Forget ghatapatadi. Take, when you say ghatapatadi, darpana is also included. So let's say that ghata will not be jiva, but darpana will be jiva. Darpana dehe bahyatva tanna iti chet. So Purvapakshi argues further. No, darpana is external, whereas antakrana is internal. That is the division whereby antakrana becomes jiva, but दर्पण इज नॉट जीव. तर्ही इति चेत् तर्ही अंतस्थानम् इंद्रियाणां तदापत्ति. इन दैट केस इंद्रियाज आर आल्सो विद इन. व्हाई नॉट कॉल इंद्रियाज एज जीव? व्हाई ओनली से दैट अंतकरण इज जीव, मीनिंग बुद्धि इज जीव. इंद्रियापेक्षा आंतरत्वात् अंतकरणस्यैव तन्न्याय्यम् इति चेत्. पूर्वपक्षी सेज ओके, इंद्रिया कंप्लीट, इंद्रियाज आर नॉट जीव because antakarana is interior, pratyak, more pratyak interior to indriyas, therefore antakarana is jiva, indriya is not jiva. Iti chet tatapi antarasya ajnanasya tadapattihi. Ajnana karana sharira is more interior to antakarana also, then why take antakarana, why not take avidya itself, karana sharira. So ajnana itself is interior, and being interior, ajnana can be jiva. Is ajnana jiva? No. Kincha jivasya chetanatvad eva na achetanasya antakkaranasya jivatvam ghatate. What is the reason? Jiva here, chetanatvad, jivasya chetanatvad achetanasya antakkaranasya jivatvam na ghatate. Achetana, wherever you see chetana lingering on, chetanavat. Not really chetana it is. Chetanatvad means what? There is sentience. You feel sentience at which level? At the jiva is chetana. We say that I am a chetana person. I am a sentient being. Whereas at ajnana level you cannot have that. And antakrana level only it is possible. But then तथापि आंतरस्य अज्ञानस्य तदापत्तिहि किंच जीवस्य चेतनत्वादेव न अचेतनस्य अंतकरणस्य जीवत्वं घटते. ओनली व्हेन देयर इज एन एसोसिएशन यू कैन हैव इट. अंतकरण इज जड़ा वेयर एज जीवा इज चेतना. सो जीवा कैन नॉट बी एट अंतकरण लेवल. आल्सो जीवत्वं इज पॉसिबल ओनली व्हेन चेतना एसोसिएशन इज देयर. सो यू कैन नॉट रूल आउट चेतना. चेतना कैन नॉट बी सेपरेटेड. Jada cannot be taken individually as jiva because jiva is sentient. You have to show sentience. So that is the refutation of antakkarana being antakkarana, buddhi alone being jiva. Kevala pratibimbasya apina jivatvam sambhavati. This pratibimba. Kevala pratibimba. What you call as abhasa otherwise. That cannot be jiva all by itself. Antakkarana rupa upadhi mantara pratibimba yogat. Why simple refutation? Pratibimba is not possible without having antakkarana or anything else as an upadhi. Upadhi cannot be let out. So antakkarana alone is not jiva. Antakkarana along with pratibimba we'll look at. But pratibimba alone cannot be jiva because pratibimba is not possible without antakkarana. Whereas antakkarana can be independent. Therefore, antakkarana refutation has been seen independently with other possibilities. In pratibimba, you don't even have that possibility because pratibimba itself has a dependency on antakkarana. Therefore, pratibimba alone cannot be jiva. Adhishthana chaitanyasya jivatva uktir asangata. What about adhishthana chaitanya alone being jiva? Asangata, that is not valid. Why? Nirvikaratva tasya vikaratmaka jivatvam na yujyate. Nirvikaratva. Adhishthana chaitanya, kutastha chaitanya, brahma chaitanya, any chaitanya by itself, chid cannot have any vikara. Nirvikaratvat. Shuddha chaitanya cannot be jiva. Then the fourth point is pratibimba option. Fourth option is pratibimba vishishtantakaranam jivaha astu iti chen. No. Then the combination of pratibimba and antakarana. You said pratibimba cannot be alone. Antakarana cannot be alone as jiva. Then how about mixing them together? Pratibimba is not possible without antakarana. Antakarana and pratibimba can go together and become jiva. Iti chet na. Ubhayoho kalpitatva visheshat. The antakarana as well as pratibimba is kalpita. Kalpitatva visheshat jivasya nityatva siddhau mukta bhava prasangat. This should be prasangat. There is a typo there. So ubhayoho kalpitatvat. There is no difference between the two. Avishesha. Both are kalpita. Pratibimba is kalpita. Adhishthana is kalpita. Meaning mithya. No, so not adhishthana, sorry. Pratibimba and antakkarana. So pratibimba and antakkarana, both are kalpita, meaning both are mithya. If kalpita is difficult to understand, how can you say... Because kalpita is difficult to understand, we use the word mithya. If mithya also people think, no, how can you say mithya? Then we say vyavaharika satta. Vyavaharika satta, mithya, kalpitatvam, all these are actually interchangeable synonyms. There is no difference between the three words. Whoever is comfortable, say Ishwara is mithya, people have a lot of trouble. Ishwara is kalpita, they'll, Dvaitins will start hitting you. Somewhere Swami Paramarthanji says, while describing something in Panchadashi, he has a way of explaining. He says, Vidyaranyacharya says this, and then the opponent comes with a stick. So, opponent is angry and he has come with a stick because, Vidyaranyacharya has called Ishwara as Mithya. Jiva and Ishwara both are Mithya. Oh, Jiva is Mithya, it's all right, but how can you call Ishwara as Mithya? So, he is a Bhakta. You cannot say Ishwara is Mithya. So, he is angry. Then you say, no, not Mithya, Satya, Vyavaharika Satya. So, this is how the three words are used. But Kalpita, Mithya and Kalpita is at a very refined level. Mandukya and Mandukya Karika level. People have difficulty with that. So, Drishti Srishti Vada is not possible. You land on Mithya. Then you explain what is Mithya. That is also difficult. Then you say, okay, Vyavaharika Satya. As long as Vyavahara is there, as long as you are not Mukta, all this will be there. Entire Prapancha will be there. You will be there as a Jiva and Ishwara will also be there. All that is fine. Even in Vyavahara, there is difference. Gradations are possible. There is a difference between a beggar and a king. There is a difference between genders. There is a difference between Prani. All Pranis, between Pranis also there is a difference. Between birds also there is a difference. Some can be domesticated, others are wild. Similarly, in human beings also, some are, domesticated, some are wild. There is a difference. At all levels in Vyavahara, there is a difference. So, obviously, Jiva is an inferior entity compared to Ishwara in Vyavahara. दैट्स एन असाइड. सो कल्पित टू एक्सप्लेन कल्पितत्व अविशेषम. कल्पित कल्पितत्व अविशेषात कस्य प्रतिबिंबस्य अंतकरणस्य अपि. देन बोथ बीइंग कल्पित और मिथ्या और व्यवहारिक सत्ता इन पारमार्थ दे हैव नो एंट्री एंड अवर मोक्ष इज पारमार्थिक लेवल. इट शुड बी नित्य त्रिकालाबाधित सत. नाउ दिस जीव, इफ जीव इज अंतकरण, अंतकरण गोइंग जीव विल गो अवे, हु विल गेट मुक्ति? अंतकरण कैनॉट गेट मुक्ति. मुक्ति इज नॉट वैनिशिंग, मुक्ति इज बीइंग प्रेजेंट ऑल द टाइम, नित्य. When jiva becomes nitya swarupena, then that is his mukti. Antakarana cannot become nitya ever. Pratibimba can also never become nitya. Therefore, nityatva siddhau, when they cannot be established at nitya, then mukta bhava prasangat, mukti will be impossible. Antakarana cannot be mukta, and thereby antakarana and pratibimba, who independently and put together also cannot be mukta. Jiva, who is a combination of antakarana and pratibimba, cannot be mukta. So mukta bhav prasanga jivasya kincha bhagatyaga lakshana asambhavat. Should be, I think, kincha bhagatyaga lakshanayaha. I think it should be lakshanayaha. Or it should be a samasa. So I think lakshanayaha should be, I think it should be, because asambhavat is there. Kasya, kasya or kasyaha is the akanksha. Kincha bhagatyaga lakshanayaha asambhavat. Nikhila vachya bhagatyaga rupa jahal lakshanayo siddhet. Then pratibimba and vishishta antak, pratibimba vishishta antakrana, pratibimba and antakrana put together a jiva. What bhagatyaga will you do? Jada has to be dropped. Pratibimba also has to be dropped. Antakarana also has to be dropped. You can't say I'll drop Pratibimba and hold on to Antakarana. There will be no Aikya with the Tatpadartha. Okay, Antakarana you drop, you hold on to Pratibimba. Still there is no Aikya with the Tatpadartha Lakshartha. So Lakshartha of Pratibimba and Antakarana is possible. Of course, it is still possible, but not by bhagatyaga lakshana, meaning jahada jahal lakshana. You have to use a different lakshana. Bhagatyaga lakshana will be asambhava, because the only two parts remaining are pratibimba and antakarana. Either one you drop, you are still holding on to something which cannot be equated on the other side at the vachyartha level of Ishvara, or at the lakshartha level of Ishvara, which happens to be Satchidananda Brahma. Therefore, if this objection is by an Advaitin who understands this Bhagatyaga Lakshana, Jadajal Lakshana, then Bhagatyaga Lakshanaya Asambhavat Nikhila Vachya Bhagatyaga Rupa Jal Lakshanaya Siddhye. Then when you give this up, you will be giving up everything which will be Jal Lakshana. So you'll have to give up the Pratibimba and Antakarana meanings both. Nothing remains. Then you have to do a lakshana by association with Chaitanya and land on Chaitanya. That is Jahati Lakshana. It is not Jahadajal Lakshana, but Jahati Lakshana. So Jahal Lakshana eva Siddhyet. Nacha etad bhashyakara abhimatam. So if the Siddhanti says, okay, let's take Jahad Lakshana, what is the problem? Siddhanti has a Puropaksha who is trying to understand the Siddhanta. Let's say the Sadhaka. He says, no, I still feel, you know, Pratibimba and Antakarana put together can be called a Jiva, and still we can land on Aikya by Jahad Lakshana. What is the problem in using Jahad Lakshana? Of course, somewhere I recall Bhagavan Sureshwaracharya in Naishkarmi Siddhi uses Jahad Lakshana also to show possibility of landing on Aikya can be done by Jahad Lakshana also. Somewhere it may be necessary, and he has shown that possibility. We need not say only Bhagatyaga Lakshana. But if you are completely committed to Bhashya and say, no, Bhagavan Bhashyakara has used only Bhagatyaga Lakshana, fine, we'll use Bhagatyaga Lakshana. If it helps you understand, see, this is my personal opinion, okay? Those who understand the Bhashya only at Bhashya level, that is fine. But those who have more questions or can, you know, can see in multiple ways, they can appreciate the Tika also. Tika is all sync with Siddhanta. And Tika itself need not be following the Bhashya completely. There can be independent Vyakhyanas also, which follow Bhashya on a broad level, but they have their independent analysis to help those kind of sadhakas to land on Aikya. So whichever prakriya works, you should hold on to that. Not every prakriya works for everyone. You can't say, no, I will understand only this way. I have to understand the Bhashya and nothing more than Bhashya, nothing less than Bhashya. And if one is not able to understand, life is wasted. You should land on the Aikya any which way.